Hey folks, this is Burstin' Slot. Welcome to Jurassic World Evolution 2 and welcome to Jurassic... Welcome to Jurassic Park. In today's video, we're going to take a closer look at the brand new decorative update that's just landed for Evolution 2. A free update for all of you arriving today, console and PC players, with a total of 22 brand new decorations, paths, fences, all that kind of stuff. Some of it taken, of course, from Jurassic Park. The return to Jurassic Park from Evolution 1, but a lot of it new and all of it pretty bloody cool. Before we hop into the individual spotlights over here, I'm just going to show you a couple of things right here from a video I recorded earlier because my recording broke, so enjoy and here we go. There was a couple of questions people have had though. First things first, the skeletons are indeed individual pieces. As you can get them pretty close together. We'll see that in just a second. We've got our log over here with our Gallimimus and our Tyrannosaurus Rex, just, you know, the way it should be. And over here, we've got our Triceratops and our big old dung piles because some things need to be done. The other big question I wanted to answer by building a little mini park like this is how the archways would work. There were a lot of people unsure whether you'd be able to walk under the new banners, the new archways and stuff like that. Well, as it turns out, you can indeed. We've got our big When Dinosaurs Ruled the Earth one right here. You could fit two chunky paths through there pretty easily. This will not clip with the path, so you can put this anywhere you want. Over here on the right, of course, we've got our classic Jurassic Park gates, and they'll sit perfectly, as you can see, over a thick path. This is a throughfare path, and the gates will sit beautifully over the middle of those. That's going to be very, very helpful. And as an added bonus, we've got these fossil walls, these kind of classic visitor center themed walls. One of those comes with an archway, and even this will work. You can put this over your path, and as long as it's a thin path, actually, even if it's a thick path, people will just walk through it. But if you put it over a thin path, as you can see, people will walk right on through. So this gives us things we've... Oh, wait, don't stop there. Don't... Come on. That was very badly timed. This is something we've really wanted for a long time. The game didn't have anything like this, and now we've got three of them in one big dose. Very exciting. Let's go check out all these decorations individually. So I will turn off Letterboxd. Oh, no, that's not a letterbox. I'll turn off letterbox. There we go. So as I say, we've got these new walls. We've got three. We've got a straight wall, as you can see here. We've got one with a doorway. We have, again, that kind of staggered approach that the visitor center entrance has. And we also have a curved one. Now, unfortunately, by default, this is as close as you can get them together. If we could overlap these, it would have been really cool because you could build a quasi-building sort of thing. As it is, you're going to use them more for backdrops and murals and stuff like that, but they're still very cool. You could use it to just curve around a path at some point, kind of using it more as a giant fence and an archway than anything else, but still very, very cool. Loads of lovely little details on there. You can see the ammonites. You can see the giant skull moving in there with some bizarrely sharp teeth. Yeah, really, really cool. There you go. I'll give you a nice individual look at all of those. Next up, we have, of course, the classic Jurassic Park gates. These were already in the game to an extent, but now they've been placed as a decoration item. They've got that staggered approach to the flames that should be there, this lovely texture on the material itself, this kind of old chiseled dark rock almost, and that lovely thick chunky Jurassic Park logo right there. You can even hear, look, it's even dirty, you can even hear the crackle of the flames. Very cool. Down here we have this little rock statue plinth thingamajiggy, this etched rock with these lovely little flowers. Just a new sign, basically. New sign, new way to showcase your park. As I said in my other video, gives me big Lost World Jurassic Park vibes for some reason. This, it just reminds me of the PS1 game where all its stuff was etched into rock. It's very, very cool. I'm a big fan of this one. I like that it doesn't pull directly from the film. You know, this is something kind of a Frontiers design. This, however, does pull from the film. When Dinosaurs Ruled the Earth, one of our other new signs, this new sign style with this big chunky piece of, like, almost girder-like metal, and then the Dinosaurs Ruled the Earth sign hangs down from the top. Speaking of murals earlier, we also have the Le Gigante. There you go. If you say it like that, it sounds better. The mural, of course, from the backside of the visitor center. Well, the kind of the divide splitting the atrium and the kitchen slash, well, the restaurant area, really. Again, looks really cool as a mural, as a backdrop for a little restaurant area. Stick some path in there, stick some new table and chairs in front of there, and you've got a really cool facsimile of the Jurassic Park visitor center. It's a really nice job of bringing this artwork, this fantastic artwork. And as I say, this is a Robert Bakker raptor, if ever there was one, to me, with these lovely little painterly parasol offices on the left. It's got a bit of a AI redone kind of vibe to it. I think it's just because it's had to be upscaled and brought to, and kind of redone, because I don't think the image is out there like in this quality. But yeah, it looks fantastic. Over here, we have the most exciting item in the entire pack. It is, of course, the log, lovingly brought to life. The log from the Gallimimus Rex scene with its tangled roots and its rugged texture. Look, we've needed a log in the game for a really long time. They are in the game as part of one of the foliages that you can put down. But this is a thing of beauty. It's not just a log, but it's a proper log. It's big and thick and chunky. And unlike the other logs, it doesn't spit like acid at people. It doesn't eat Dennis Nedry. It's a beautiful log, and I'm immensely happy to have it in the game. Lovely texture. Gonna go in basically every exhibit I ever build from now on. Moving on. We have our Mr. DNA statue, one of the less expected ones. Oh my god, get into position. He's even got, you can just see his little tongue there. His little tongue, he's got those big eyes. He's got little eyebrows hanging up. And then that's all kind of flat like he is. And then these are all, your genome is bobbly and like a big old balloon. Just a very cool little thing. Some of these do light up as well, so we'll switch over to nighttime in a little bit and check those out. Quiet, Rexy. Down here, we have the new table and chairs. Just pulled from the restaurant. They kind of look like they're melting, but that's kind of sexy. New table and chairs from the restaurant in the visitor center, as I say. Stick these in front of that mural from before, Le Gigante. It looks really good. Over here, we have our skeletons. Now, you've already seen these, so I've decided to put them as close together as I possibly could to kind of make it look like they're tussling. You'd maybe want to separate it a little bit more than this. This kind of looks like they're doing a lovely romantic dance more than anything else, I would suggest. But it is cool that you can get them this close. You can get them like awkwardly close, honestly, like too close. But our Alamosaurus and Tyrannosaurus Rex, beautiful things. I would love to see even more of these in the game. I know these ones make sense because they're for Jurassic Park, but I think this is largely the kind of decoration a lot of us would love to see more of, like a little raptor skeleton would be awesome. Stuff like that to sort of round out the decorations in our park. But this is a fantastic step in the right direction, and it's really, really well modeled. This can't have been an easy job, but they've done a really beautiful job. Over here, we have our When Dinosaurs Ruled the Earth kind of sign. Now, I don't think we can put these together, but, you know, certain ways to do that, maybe. Hanging that over the top for those two would be awesome. But it does look really good. Like we've seen already, it can act as an archway. The banner, again, really nicely rendered, really nicely put to life. Got a little bit of a paper, fabric-y sort of texture going on there as well. Down here, we've got some dung. It's exciting. Unironically, this is really good for like naturalistic sort of exhibits. And I saw a comment from someone, I can't remember who, asking, hoping that there would be flies buzzing around it. And they're quite hard to see, but you can spot them. If you just keep an eye out on the screen right now. Hopefully YouTube isn't compressing it too hard, but you can see little buzzy flies buzzing around, doing buzzy things. And a nice little detail here, you can see sort of straw and fiber inside of here because, you know, it's from the Triceratops habitat. It's going to be eating grass and it's going to have this kind of aesthetic. I just slip at least one in there to its feces. Moving on, over here we have the bunker, the classic security bunker. I did mistakenly confuse this with the power bunker in the last video, so somebody needs to revoke my Jurassic Park fan card. But yeah, this looks really good. This was, I believe, if I remember correctly, the Return to Jurassic Park bunker, and it didn't make it into the sequel. But we do have the bunker, the power bunker, the bunker from Sattler and Muldoon's combat with the raptors, and it does have the big things hanging over the top and that kind of Lost World slightly vibe and the little pipe over there on the left-hand side. It looks like it's agape, doesn't it? It looks like a giant smiley. It's this big-ass mouth and then these two eyes just boring into your soul. But really, really well rendered. Over here, we've got our new paths. So this is your new facility path, your new. So you only get a skinny version of this one. It's got this kind of asphalt sort of texture, just a bit warmer, a little bit more brown in there, kind of suits Jurassic Park as a vibe. These are, again, pulled from Return to Jurassic Park. The second one we have is this one. It's kind of a more brown version of that one. It's kind of a bit more of a rugged stone with sort of dirt lying in between the gaps and then this grey brick highlighting it. And then my favourite of the bunch, your fancy path, which is this tiled one here, individually cracked. And then, as with the last time, these lovely little metal symbols in the middle representing the Jurassic Park logo. So beginner path, middle path, expert path. Basically, you've got all three right there. Let me hop in and out of capture mode to fix that. Right, so a couple more things still to go. Already quite a lot of stuff for a free update, ladies and gentlemen. Not a penny to pick all this stuff up for yourselves. All of your games will get it at some point today, probably in the next hour or two, based on the usual time frames. But we also have a new fence. This is the new light fence. Please tell me this is the correct one, because I don't know the fences that well for some reason, and I got it wrong last time as well, and I'm pretty sure this is the new fence, the very classic Jurassic Park fence. It should be lilted forward, but you do see it straight up as well on some exhibits, and it's just it's a new thin light electric fence, basically. These big ol' pillars kind of pointing in both directions, this thin cable between. And every now and again, oh no, that's not related to that. And then every now and again, you get these signs as well, these danger electric warning signs, which do look like that in the film, which is really cool. I recreated this in Prehistoric Kingdom, and it looks exactly like that. So that's really cool to see. And of course, you will have got a glimpse now over here. My beloved, my favorite part of the pack, maybe, unironically, the new range gate, vehicle gate, whatever you want to call it. Functions like all the other gates in the game, so you could use it for... I don't know if your dinosaurs can walk through it. I'm going to have to... I will find that out and put it in this video, because it does function like all the other gates, you know, the normal ones, but it is a two-tier gate, you know, there's two doorways. I'd be very curious to see a dinosaur walk through it. I'll find out and let you know, but again, brilliantly rendered. Like I say, I've made this myself, and I know it's a fairly complex piece of work. I didn't make this one, obviously, but it's got all the little details in there, the little thing that hangs down, the two-tone lights on there. This is the thing that sort of shunts across very aggressively. We've got high voltage signs, and yeah, really just, it's just a great aesthetic, isn't it? It's only the second time. Right, one last thing. We have a new Jurassic Park pylon. Again, I believe these were in Return to Jurassic Park, but there you go. You've got that much chunkier, much thicker, much more old school look to them. I've got these kind of diodes, transformers, fuses in the middle, and then these thick cables stretching across, and this little sort of pokey antenna looking thing at the top. Just big chunky things, and then we've got that classic sort of concrete Jurassic Park style. Thick girder like metal and chunky angular concrete. That is the Jurassic Park aesthetic, and this pack really brings it to life in a very cool way. So all of that is 22 brand new items to Evolution. Okay, not brand new, but you know what I mean. 22 new additions to Evolution 2 as part of the free update. I really didn't think they were going to go this hard. I thought we maybe get 3 or 4 new decorations, but this pack has really, it's been superb. Yeah, way more than I expected. Really glad to see this come to life. Now, before we go, and this is all I have to show you, I'm going to test out that dinosaur thing. It should work, right? But I just want to see it happen. Well, there you go, folks. Crossing over. It looks really cool, actually. It looks really good as well. I think it's just going to be your Gallimimus and smaller. Gallimimus is probably a good example of the largest sort of dinosaur that's going to fit through there. I don't think your Hadrosaurs, for example, are going to be fitting through there either. It's just your Gallimimus and then your smaller ones as well. And there goes Rexy right through the gate because, yeah. So that is it from me. A really, really cool little update. Definitely want to do like a, you know, I want to do a horror park inspired by just Jurassic Park. I think that would be a lot of fun. But we'll see what we come up with. Definitely a fantastic update. Can't wait to see what you will build with it as well. Let me know what part of this, what is your most hyped up decoration other than the log? Because that's the obvious answer, obviously. What's your most excited? What decoration are you most excited about in the pack? And yeah, let me know what you think when you get hold of it yourselves later on today. Thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks very, very soon. Cheers much of us always. Oh, throw me a like if you enjoyed the video. That would make you cool beans. Don't you want to be cool beans? Of course you want to be cool beans. Everybody wants to be cool beans. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much of us always. Bye-bye.